Amber Code. Amber Code what?
Dominican Republic.
Oh, that's what this is? Amber Cove, Dominican Republic. It's actually officially the first port. Carnival Magic.
Had a great breakfast, and last night wasn't so good.
Here we go. Let's just check it out.
See him?
Okay, so when you come to Amber Cove, it may rain. It's pretty misty, a little light shower. It was raining pretty good earlier. It was actually pouring. But weather's nice. Weather is beautiful. Tropical, Caribbean, all that good stuff. But you'll enjoy it. Here we go. Okay then. They have some pretty amazing views out there. You see that background back there? It's a beautiful island. Beautiful people. Let's go down to the sun. It's nice. Enjoying. As long as it doesn't rain, I'm enjoying it. Get ready for our next port. Southern Lights. Yes, okay, so it's Tuesday and we're almost St. Thomas. Breakfast time here in the Southern Lights restaurant on the Carnival Magic. Of course, you guys know that by now. We're on the Carnival Magic and looking forward to some great breakfast. So we just docked at the beautiful St. Thomas, U.S. Virgin Islands. As you can see, it's behind me. Looking oh so beautiful. So we're waiting for a little while, let the crowd die down. Then we'll go down and check out the island. So we're about to check out the island of St. Thomas. arrive at St. Thomas.
Okay. So the course information is right here.
Okay, information.
This way is a sure thing.
Jail. Today settled down to the museum, which they're doing a little construction on the inside. But it was also used for the buying and selling of the slaves.
Oh,
we cannot go forget about that. It's still what it was. The military is the one that separated in the year of 1800. Mr. and Mrs. Attle actually bought that island. They actually buried on top. You see there's a nice mountain area. There's some tombstone on that island over there. Okay, they bought the island, they're buried on the island. Only the family members live on that island. You also have a nice mountain area right down to the front. They also use that area there for filming the TV show, the Real World commercial and whatnot on our island. Now, St. Thomas is a beautiful island, but what happened is only a peak time, which is November through April. The another 6 months is very slow, and when I mean very slow, very slow. So a lot of people on the island, what they do, they go elsewhere and they pick up a job to make up for the other 6 months.
What is that? This is nice. Wanna say hi? Wanna say hi? Huh? This is awesome. This is beautiful.
Where's Dad? Thank you, sir. Been here, play here. Tiger Woods. Our last person I see down here was Oprah Winfrey. They all come on vacation just like you guys. When Bobby Brown and Whitney Houston was together, when she was alive, they was on our island. Harrison Ford, just like you want to enjoy a little bit, they do come down here to enjoy a lot also.
Downtown St. Thomas.
Cousins.
Here we have some barbecue, peas and rice, macaroni and cheese. With a salad on the side. Shrimp. Looks like you need some
food. You probably got a read.
Nothing wrong.
We'll sell that one. I'll keep him. Oh, yeah, that's cool. I'll keep him as a hold
show. You don't need a bag.
This is the real deal here.
Oh. Yeah, it looked like a
yeah. This is broken down into sections. You think your AK has a scope? I have a scope too. Scope comes off separate. This is to display your dots. And this is my secret compartment. And these are the bad boys right here. So all we're gonna do now, once you get your little poison, you make sure you roll that around and the little gooey stuff, let it dry. Once the, everything is set up, and you start from the end, this is the end. That goes in. Once it hits you, break your skin, within seconds, you're done. No last will and testament, no goodbyes, no put me in your favorite shoes. Sign my will. Nothing. Raymond gets the red Lexus. You ain't gonna say none of that. Okay? Lights out.
So we're checking out the market out here at St. Thomas.
Oh my god!
Is this her lead?
Oh man, crime. Crime is like food. It's like every place.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Ups and downs.
Is it better to be back on the ship when it gets dark then, or is it about the same as everywhere?
Not really, but you know, nothing much here to do when it comes to nightlife.
Oh, okay.
It's not like before.
Store to go see all
so
the
I would take you. So what I would do, like, this is how I would, like, give you 2-for-1. You see the city and still take it home. You kind of have time to do it. Not take it to 3 places and make you stay there. Stand up there. This is a tree. And we stand there 20 minutes. You can watch the tree in 2 minutes and still take you all the way. Only 32 square miles. Yep.
Carnival magic. It's about 7 o'clock, a little after 7. And we'll be off to San Juan, Puerto Rico in the morning. We should be there by 8 in the morning. And I'll get to show you guys what San Juan, Puerto Rico looks like. All right, see y'all in a minute. Good morning, beautiful people. It's Wednesday. We have arrived in the beautiful San Juan, Puerto Rico. So let's take a look and see what San Juan looks like. We're actually about to get off the ship and go explore Puerto Rico. Here we go.
Thank you.
Love grabbing women around. He loves grabbing women around the waist.
Just having fun. I'm on vacation,
babe. I want to take the picture.
That adventure out here in San Juan, Puerto Rico, enjoying beautiful scenery.
Guys, there's a color code in San Juan. Now this is the area where you're going to see a lot of colors on the houses. The reason why you see colors on the houses different is because the color code says that if you paint your house same as your neighbor, you're going to get fined $100 a day until you paint it in a different color. Okay? That's how it is here.
$10. $6, $10.
So how are you enjoying San Juan, Puerto Rico so far?
Pretty cool.
Pretty cool? Like?
I think that one my souvenir is on the way.
Okay.
I think. I do have one coworker who's very near and dear to my heart, so I may have to pick up something else. That would be Miss Dara. I love Miss Dara.
This breeze feels fantastic. I gave it to the other guy.
No more change. Sorry, sir.
These people are going back to this ship.
There's a hat over there.
What hat? Puerto Rico hat? She got her Puerto Rican hat.
Now we can go for her to eat and then get back on the ship.
So we both can wear it now.
Right. It's kind of too big and he made it small.
So I'm about to catch a show tonight. The missus didn't want to come to the show, so I said, hey, I'll check out the show tonight. After eating some great salmon. So let's see what the show is about. See you guys at the show. At our last port, Grand Turk, or what's the other name?
Turks and Caicos.
We're gonna tour the island of Grand Turk. See what it is out here on the island. Shout out to everybody out here in Grand Turk. What's up? Boy Big Vic is in the building.
There is the little capsule there to the right, that Ramesset John Glass. They said this is where he has landed. And if you look over to the far, far right, that's James McCartney International Airport. Over to the far right, so a little tire shop on the hand. On the left is a little money transfer called CAM. You can send money all over the world. We have our crazy bargain store right here on the hand. That's where you can go and bargain like you're crazy inside of there. Our Do-It Center, our building material store to the left. That's the little one we call our little Home Depot there. And one of our telecommunication companies, Digicel. You know, we have two telecommunication companies. We have Digicel and we have Lime. And we have two buildings up ahead of us on the left, under construction. These two buildings right here. They are owned by Serena Williams, the tennis player.
Okay.
These two buildings are to my left. They are owned by Serena Williams, the tennis player. And if you look over to the far right, guys, you can see that lovely, beautiful two-story building over there. Most of the folks, they ask me if that is the church. Well, that's not a church, ladies and gents. That is the courthouse. But that's what the guys call it when they have to go to court. They say, we are going to church this morning. But anyway, guys, you know the crime rate is really low here in the island, about 4 to 5%. We don't have any killing and stabbing and shooting and stuff like that here in the island. Because as I told you folks, we live just like family. Everybody knows just about everybody. So there's nobody to kill, guys. It's called Grand Turk Inn. That is a lovely little bed and breakfast. And we have the oldest bank in the Tucson Caicos, CIBC, First Caribbean. That is the oldest bank in the Tucson Caicos. Back in Red Bronx, they were placed there for representation of Christopher Columbus. And they said he was the first to discover the Tucson Caicos. Well, ladies and gents, Ben Christopher Columbus did came to the Tucson Caicos. He had met the Lucaya Indians here farming in the island. And he had killed all of those Indians because he wanted when he go back to England to the Crane, to tell the Queen that he was the first to discover the Tucson Caicos.
There you go.
But the Queen didn't believe him. She loaded him up with a few more prisoners, a few more demons, sent him back around the world. So when he got back here to the Tucson Caicos, they met nobody here. So that's why they're saying Christopher Columbus was the first to discover the Tucson Caicos. Down the alleyway to the right, you look on the wall to see Her Majesty's prison. Well, ladies and gents, Danny is no longer a prison. Because you can see this is just about in the middle of our little town. And we don't want a prison down in the middle, having those prisoners mingling with you tourists.
We're here on the Turks and Caicos Island. Visiting their shopping area. Thirty minutes too. It's probably 75 too. We're about to watch a movie on the big screen. We found the perfect seats.